Greetings! My name is Steve, I am a musician, and today I'll be listening for the very first time to a new song by Badflower called Don't Hate Me. I listened recently and reacted to one of their songs called Family, which I very much enjoyed. I've not heard Don't Hate Me before, so I'm excited to see what it's like, because I do like Badflower. They can be quite meaningful vocally, and the music tends to be pretty good. We're gonna see, and go. Ah, cutting lyrics. This man needs a hug. The production on this is amazing. The drums are so fat. You can hear the bass clearly. There's the guitars. Muted picking on it. Sounds like Nirvana a bit. It's catchy. Interesting. There's a sense of that chorus, the guitars are changing chords, but there's overwhelming like root note within it. I don't know how they did that, it must be just an additional guitar track maybe. Ooh. Oh, skipping that beat. You expect a kick drum, it's not there. And the snare drum is late. It's quite a subdued chorus. Oh man, that drum fill was nice. Oh. The drum fills wrapping around my head. Nice. It's a 4-4 song, but the vocal moments were kind of 6-8 maybe. It's cool. I want to start singing along, and it's the first time I've ever heard it. That's a good sign. What? I've never heard Badflower do that before. Didn't. Degent. That's cool. There's a piano in there. The drummer's having some fun right now. Piano, man. Bit of like electro something in the background there. Interesting. Ending on a piano chord. Interesting choice. I guess it added a sort of classic gravitas to the moment there. All right. Don't Hate Me by Badflower. A lot to digest there, I think. That there were moments in there that sounded like a modern pop rock version of Nirvana. I don't know how to quantify that, but there's something about the melody choice and the way that he was singing it in the verses and the music backed it up made me think of that. The production on this recent record, I say record because I'm assuming there's an album involved, this song and Family, the drums sound, the kick drum sounds full and present in your ears, the snare is exact. When they hit the fills, you can feel it wrapping around your head. It's amazing to hear. Guitars are well layered, really well, what is the word I'm looking for here? Isolated, isn't it? Like, in the frequency of the, I'm getting too deep now. In the frequency of the song, they have their own slice in the frequencies that they exist, so it's kind of clear and punchy without washing away all the bass and stuff. Pretty well produced. Lyrically, on brand, I would say, for Badflower. What I like about them is they're very honest. I'm assuming it's most, I say they, he, I don't know. Very introspective, raw, vulnerable, honest vocals. And cool, because that lends itself to a lyrical hook in the chorus, say, that most people can all relate to. We just don't necessarily think about or allow ourselves to recognize that in ourselves. So that gives it kind of some power and meaning. It's not just, they're not just writing a song to write a song. They're writing a song because there's something that they want to say. And I like that. That's pretty cool. Cool. And yeah, there were moments in there after the second chorus, I think it was, when I had a kind of breakdown moment. They went to a different section before the final chorus. And they had the like, sort of degent, like heavy, metally moments within what is kind of a sedate rock ballad song, which was an excellent surprise, which I very much enjoyed. So thank you for that. More of that, please. Great. That's a fucking great song. Don't Hate Me by Badflower. Thank you, Badflower, for the new music. That was, yeah, I need to use another word other than great, because I use great a lot. That was marvelous. Is what that was. It was a marvelous song, so thank you for that. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this, and see you next time.